The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 2nd, 1968, in Los Angeles.
Govindam Adipurusantam Aham Vajami
Govindam
So, we are worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Govinda. That is our business. And what is the effect of worshipping Govinda? Just like people are trying to go to the moon planet, very teeny effort, even they go to the moon planet, they will be not very much benefited. Because the scientists say the moon planet is below 200 degrees, 0 point. So we cannot tolerate the cold climate of this planet. How we shall be benefited if we go to the moon planet? And moon planet is the nearest planet. There are millions of other planets also. And the scientists say that to reach the highest, topmost planet, it will take 40,000 of years. And who is going to leave for 40,000 years to go and come back? These are practical difficulties, and therefore we are called conditioned souls. Our activities are conditioned, not free. But you can attain a life of freedom, life of unlimited energy, unlimited happiness, unlimited bliss. There is possibility. This is not a story or fiction. We see so many planets within this universe. We have got so many flying vehicles. But we cannot approach even to the nearest. We are so much limited. But if we worship Govinda, then it is possible. We can go anywhere. We have written these statements in our small booklet, Easy Journey to Other Planets. This is possible. Don't think that this planet is all in all. There are many, many, millions of other very nice planets. There the standard of happiness, standard of enjoyment is many more times greater than what we are enjoying here. So, how this is possible, I shall read the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, which is spoken by Govinda himself. Bhagavad Gita, 7th chapter. Lord Krishna says, Maya Saptamana Pārta Jogam Jinyana Vadasraya Atam Sang Samadhavan Jatha Vyasasi Tachino. Now, here the word Jogam is also explained. What sort of yoga Krishna is recommending? Maya Sakta Mana. keeping the mind always attached to Krishna. This yoga system. This Krishna consciousness is yoga system that at the present day they are concentrating their mind on something void, impersonal, according to their own prescription. The real process is to concentrate the mind on something. But that something, if we make it void, it is very difficult to concentrate our mind in that way. That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 12th chapter. Klesha adhikatarastesham abhakta saktachetasa. Those who are trying to meditate on something impersonal and void, their trouble is greater than those who are meditating on the Supreme Person. This is explained. Why? Abhaktya hi gati dukham deha vadhi abhapate. We cannot concentrate our mind something impersonal. If you think of your friend, if you think of your father, mother, or somebody whom you love, you can continue such thinking for hours together. But if you have no objective to fix up your mind, then it is very difficult. But people are being taught to concentrate on something void and impersonal. So in reply to that mode of yoga, Krishna is directly speaking here, Maya Saptamana. If you try to concentrate your mind on the form of Krishna, so beautiful, he is enjoying with Radharani and his associates, then Maya Saptamana was the yoga. If you practice this yoga, Madasaya Jinyan Madas, you have to practice this yoga. At the same time, you have to take shelter of Krishna. Mad Asraya. Asraya means under my protection. This is called surrender. If you go to a friend in a difficult position and you surrender to your friend, my dear friend, you are so great, so powerful, so influential, I am in this great danger, so I surrender unto you. You please give me protection. So, you can do that to Krishna. Here in the material world, if you surrender to a person, however very big he may refuse. He may say, I am unable to give you protection. That is the natural reply. If you are in danger, and if you go into your intimate friend, please give me protection, he will hesitate, because his power is very limited. He'll first of all think that if I give protection to this person, whether my interest will not be jeopardized. He'll think like that, because his potency is limited. But Krishna is so nice that he is so powerful, he is so opulent. He declares in the Bhagavad Gita, everyone, sarvadhanman parityajya mamekam saranam vaje. You leave aside everything, you simply surrender unto me. And what is the result? result is ahankar sarva papi bha mukhe shami. I shall get you release from all kinds of reaction of your sinful life. This material world, our activities, are all sinful activities. There is action and reaction. Whatever you are doing, there is action and reaction. Even there is good reaction, still it is sinful. Still it is sinful. Just like according to Vedic literature, the pious activities, the result of pious activities. Janmai sadya suta srivi. Suppose you are not acting anything sinful in this life. You are very pious in every respect. You are charitable. You are benevolent. Everything is all right. But Bhagavad Gita says that it is karma bandhana. If you give in charity somebody, say some amount of money, you will get that money back 4 times, 5 times, or 10 times more in your next life. That is a fact. So, Vaishnava philosophy says that this is also sinful. Why sinful? Now, because you have to take your birth to receive that compound interest. That is sinful. Now, suppose you are born in a very rich family. The trouble of being in the womb of the mother, that is the same. Either you are pious man or the impious man. When you are in the womb of your mother, the difficulties and the pains perceived within the womb of the mother is the same. Either you are black or white, either you are Indian or American, or cat or dog or anyone. Janmamrityu jarabhyadi dukkho dosan darshan. The troubles of birth, the troubles of death, and the troubles of disease, and the troubles of old age are everywhere the same. It is not that because you are born in a very rich family, you will be immune from diseases. It is not that you will not become old. It is not that you will be saved from the troubles of birth, or you will be saved from the troubles of death. So these things have to be understood very clearly. But people have become so unintelligent, they do not care for death, all right, death, let it come. Now especially in these days, a child is in the womb of the mother. So many killing processes are there. So many. Why? Because people are becoming so much entangled that such person even do not get birth. In the womb of the mother, he is placed and he is killed. Again he is placed in another womb of mother. Again he is killed. In this way he does not see even the light. So, to become in the womb of the mother and to again accept death, to accept old age, accept disease, is not very good business. If you are rich man, you have to accept all these troubles of material existence. Or if you are poor man, it doesn't matter. Anyone who comes into this material world with this material body, he has to take all these troubles. It may be that you are American, the richest nation in the world. That does not mean there is no disease, there is no old age, there is no birth, there is no death. So the intelligent person is he who can make a solution of these problems. He is intelligent. Others who are making patchwork, patching, trying to make a solution of the problems of material life, although they are unable, it is not possible. If you want to make a solution of material existence by the material way, it is not possible. That is also clearly stated in the Bhagavad Gita. You will find, Daividhesa gunamai mama maya durattaya. This material nature, which is accepted, claimed by Krishna as my energy, mama maya, this is also another energy of Krishna. Everything will be explained in the 7th chapter. So, it is very difficult to get out of this energy. Practically we are seeing what we are, our efforts are very tiny to conquer over the laws of the material nature. It is simply waste of time. You cannot become happy by conquering over the material nature. Now science has discovered so many things. Just an aeroplane from India, it would have taken months together to reach your country. But by aeroplane we can come here overnight. These advantages are there. But along with these advantages, there are so many disadvantages. When you are on the plane, on the sky, you know you are in the midst of danger. At any moment, there can be crash. You may fall down on the sea, you may fall down anywhere. So it is not very safe. Then similarly, any method we manufacture, we discover to conquer over the laws of material nature, it is backed by another set of dangerous things. That is the law of nature. So that is not the way to get out of this material pants of life. The real way is to stop this. Four functions of my conditional life. The four functions of conditional life means birth, death, old age and disease. Actually, I am a spirit soul. That is explained in the beginning of Bhagavad Gita, that the spirit soul is never born or is never dead. He continues his life even after the destruction of this particular type of body. This body is only a flesh for some years only, but it will be finished. It is being finished by degrees. Just like I am an old man, I am 73 years old. Suppose if I live 80 years, 100 years, these 73 years have already died. That is finished. Now, few years, I may remain. So we are dying from the death of our birth. That is a fact. So Bhagavad Gita gives you the solution of these four problems. And Krishna here is suggesting, Maya saptamana prastha jubam junjan jalas madasya. If you take shelter of Krishna, and if you think of Krishna always, your consciousness becomes always overwhelmed with Krishna thoughts, then Krishna says, the result will be, asamsang samagram maa, jatha jnashasi tatshin. Then you will understand me perfectly, without any doubt. Everyone is hankering after what is God. What is the nature of God? Somebody says there is no God. Somebody says there is God is dead. These are all doubts. But here Krishna says, Asamsa, he'll be doubtless. He'll feel, he'll know perfectly well that God is there, Krishna is there. And he is the source of all energy. He is the primal Lord. This thing you'll learn without any doubt. The first thing is, we do not make progress in transcendental knowledge on account of doubts. This doubt can be removed by culture of real knowledge, by real association, by following the real methods. The doubts can be removed. The Krishna consciousness persons, they are not after will-o'-the-wisp or phantasmagoria. No. They're actually making progress to the concrete Supreme Personality of Godhead. As it is stated in the Brahma Sangita, Chintamani prakarasadamasu kalpa brikhalakhyabhritesu suravhiravipalayam. There is a planet which is called Chintamani Dham, goal of Vrindavan. So, in that dhama, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, madhyama, dhama means his abode. Krishna says, I have got an abode, particular. How can deny? How is that abode? That is also described in Bhagavad Gita and many other Vedic literature. Jadgatyana nivartante tadhyama paramangmam. Here, any dhamma, any planet you go, either not by Sputnik, even by natural birth, any planet you go, just like we have got in this planet. But we have to go back from this planet. You will not be allowed to stay here. You are Americans, that's all right. But how long is shall remain America? These people, they do not understand it. You will have to go back and some other planet and some other place. You cannot say, no, I shall remain here. I have got my visa or my permanent citizenship. No. This is not allowed. One day death will come. Please exit. No, sir, I've got so many business. No. Damn your business. Come on. You see? But if you go to Krishna Loka, Krishna says, Jadgatyana nivatsanti, you haven't got to come back again. Jadgatyana nivatsanti tadhyamam paramangmam. This is also Krishna's dham. Because everything belongs to God, Krishna. Nobody is proprietor. This claim that this land, America, belongs to us, United States, this is false claim. It does not belong to you, nobody else. Just like some years ago, 400 years ago, it belonged to the Indians, Red Indians, and somewhere other, you have now occupied. Who can say that the others will not come here and occupy? So this is all false claim. Actually, everything belongs to Krishna. Krishna says that, Sarvaloka Maheshwara, I am the supreme proprietor, controller of all planets. So everything belongs to him. But Krishna says everything belongs to him, so everything is his dharma, his place, his abode. So why should he change here? But he says, jadgatya na nivartante tadhyamam paramam. Paramam means the supreme. In these dhamma also they are Krishna's dhamma, Krishna's planet. But here it is not parama, the supreme. There are troubles. Just like this birth, death, disease and old age. But if you return to Krishna's personal abode, Goloka Vrindavan, Chintamani Dham, then you get eternal life, blissful life, full of knowledge. And how that can be achieved? Here it is beginning. Krishna says that maya saptamana. Simply you increase your attachment for Krishna. Simply, this method. These all these we are chanting, we are hearing, we are dancing, we are enjoying. Why? Just to detach our life from all nonsense things and attach to Krishna. This is Krishna. You have to make your mind attached to something. But if you make your mind attached to something nonsense, then the same thing, janma mrityu jarabhyadhi, birth, death, old age, disease, you have to suffer. Your science, your material science, nothing, no, nobody can make any solution of this suffering. But if you want real solution, permanent solution, permanent life, then you become attached to Krishna. Simple method. Maya sakta manaprat. Yogam jinyan. That is the perfect form of yoga. All other yogas may help you to come to this platform of Krishna consciousness. But if you fail to come to this platform of Krishna consciousness, then all those troubles will be useless labor. But that is not possible. If you take that slow process of yoga, it is not possible in this age, not only in this age, 5,000 years ago also. This is not possible. You may do your gymnastic feats, but it will never be successful. This yoga process, as it is confirmed by Krishna in the last chapter, this is 7th chapter and the 6th chapter also, he has said the very thing, that yoginam api sarvesham, the first class yogi is he whose mind is always attached to me, Krishna. So this is Krishna consciousness. Try to understand Krishna consciousness. Simply by practicing this, somehow or other, you become attached to Krishna. Somehow, jena tena prakare. Anyway, just like if you love somebody, anyway you try to get it. It is not very difficult. We know the tactics. Even an animal he knows how to get his things tactfully. The struggle for existence means that everyone is trying to get his objective. So many tactics. So he also tries, instead of after this material wheel of the wheel, you somehow tactfully try to catch that Krishna. That will make your life successful. Somehow. Maya ena tena prakarena mana krishna nidesha. Sarve vidhi nishira su retaya reva pinkara. Now there are so many in Krishna consciousness problems. This process, there are so many. I am just introducing one after another, little by little. But those who are practicing this Krishna consciousness in India, there are so many rules and regulations. Somebody says the Swamiji is very conservative, he has got so many rules and regulations, but I am not even introduced 1%. 1%. Because it is not possible to introduce all those rules and regulations in your country. My policy is following the footsteps of Rupa Goswami. He says that somehow or other, let them become first of all attached to Krishna. That is my policy. And rules and regulations, they will do it later on. First of all, let him be attached to Krishna. So this is the yoga. Krishna is explaining, maya sakta mana pratha. So try to be attached to Krishna. And why you shall not be attached to Krishna? So many nice things in Krishna consciousness. We have got art. We have got painting, we have got dancing, we have got music, we have got first class food, we have got first class dress, first class health, everything first class. It is only the foolish rascal that he will not be attached to this factor. And it is easy at the same time. What is the reason that one should not be attached to this process? The reason is that he is a first-class rascal. That's all. A fellow friend, let anyone come, argue with me, whether he is not a first-class rascal by not accepting Krishna consciousness. I'll prove it. So, don't be first-class rascal. Become first-class intelligent. As Chaitanya Charitamrita author says, Krishna je bhaje sevara chotu. Anyone who has taken to Krishna consciousness, he is first-class intelligent man. So don't be first-class fool, but become first-class intelligent man. That is my request. Thank you very much. Any question? So many students came. No, nobody. Because they want to remain the first-class rascal. That's all. That is. It is a fact. So unless one is very intelligent, they cannot take to Krishna consciousness. They want to be bluffed, cheated, in this way, that way, that's all. Plain thing, simple thing, and result is very great, they will not agree. Yes.
There are so many stories of Lord Chaitanya converting so many rascals by just his presence in the chant by Krishna. How can we give His mercy so that we can help the people around us to chant?
If you chant sincerely this mantra, everything will be clear. It is the clearing process. Even if you have got some rascal idea, rascal association, it doesn't matter. Simply, if you chant, you know practically, everyone, that the chanting process is the only method that will make people advance. So this is the method, chanting and hearing. Here, the lectures from Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, try to understand and chant and follow the rules and regulations. So rules and regulations later on. First of all, you try to hear and chant. Sinnatang Sarada Krishna Punnasavana Kirtana. Punnasavana Kirtana. Anyone who hears Hare Krishna, he becomes pious simply by hearing. He becomes purified. So at a stage, he will accept. But people think that what is this Hare Krishna chanting? You see? If you give them some black Kula Kundalini Yoga, and all these humbugs, they will be very much pleased. So they want to be cheated. And some cheaters come, yes, you take this mantra, give me $35, and within 6 months you become God, you will have 4 hands. So we want to be cheated. That is, cheating process is one of the item of conditional life. There are 4 defects of conditional life. One defect is that we commit mistake. And another defect is that we accept something which is not that. Just like commit mistake, that's not to be very difficult to understand. Every one of us know how we commit mistake. Blunder, even great men, they also commit blunder, you see. Just like, there are so many instances amongst the politicians, a little mistake, great blunder. So mistake to every human, mistake is there. Similarly, accepting something as fact which is not fact. How it is that just like everyone in the conditioned life, they think that this body is like myself. But I am not this. I am not this body. So this is called illusion, pramana. The best example is to accept a rope as a snake. Suppose in the darkness there is a rope like this, and you are like, oh, here is a snake. This is the best example of illusion. Accepting something which is not that. So this defect is there in conditioned life. And to make error and mistake, that defect is there. And the third defect is that we want to cheat and we want to be cheated. We are also very expert. We are always thinking how I shall cheat somebody. And naturally he is also thinking to cheat me. So the whole conditional life is the association of cheaters and cheated. That's all. So this is another defect. And the fourth defect is that our senses are imperfect. Therefore all knowledge that we receive, that is imperfect knowledge. A man may speculate, but he may speculate with his mind. That's all. But his mind is imperfect. However you may speculate, he will produce something nonsense. That's all. Because his mind is imperfect. It doesn't matter that if you add thousands of zeros, it makes one. No, it is still zero. So the speculation process to understand the Supreme is nothing but zero. Therefore, with all these defects of our conditioned life, it is not possible to come to the real life. Therefore, we have to take it from personalities like Krishna and his bona fide representative. That is real knowledge. Then we will get perfection.
What is the difference between an infallible and an avatar?
Avatar is incarnation. Avatar means incarnation. Incarnation in your dictionary is accepting somebody, is that? But avatar, of course there are different grades of avatar. And avatar means one who comes, the real word is avataran, descending. Avatar means who comes from a higher sphere, higher planet. They are not living entities of this world, this material world. They come from spiritual world. They are called avatar. So these avatar grades are different. There are Saptavis avatar, Guna avatar, Lila avatar, Yuga avatar, so many. Avatar means one who comes directly from the spiritual world. And incarnation, of course, this avatar is translated with the word incarnation, but I think the real meaning of incarnation means to accept the body. Is it not? So that incarnation, everyone accepts a material body. But avatar, there are avatar of Vishnu and avatar of devotees also. There are different grades of avatar. We will read it in the teachings of Lord Chaitanya, which is coming out.
In chapter 12, in Bhagavad Gita, as it is, it said that Arjuna was imprisoned at the speaking of Bhagavad Gita to the Sun God so many years ago. What
in
position did he have there?
He was also present, but he has forgotten.
What position did he have if it wasn't spoken at the battle of Kurukshetra? What position?
Arjuna was put into that position by the supreme will of the Lord. Unless just like in the theatrical stage, both the father and the son, they are playing some part. The father is playing of a king and the son is playing of another king, both are inimical. But actually they are playing as such. Similarly, Arjuna is eternal friend of Krishna. He cannot be in delusion. How he can be in delusion? If Krishna is his constant friend. But you are supposed to be in delusion so that he played the part of a conditioned soul and Krishna explained the whole thing. He played the ordinary person. Therefore, all his questions are just like ordinary man. Unless, because the teachings of Gita was lost, that is explained. So Krishna wanted to deliver again the yoga system of Gita. So somebody must ask, just like you are asking, I'm answering. Similarly, Arjuna, although he was not to be supposed in illusion, he placed himself as representative of this conditioned soul and he inquired so many things, the answers were given by God.
When I'm serving this, I feel very nice, but then when I think of how bad and imperfect the service is, I feel terrible. Which is right to feel?
You feel terrible?
Yeah.
When you feel terrible?
When I see all the blunders I make, all the mistakes.
Sometimes, this is nice to accept the blunders. Even there is no blunder. This is the symptom of sincere service. Just like a father is very beloved to his son, or the son is very beloved to the father, a little ailments of the son, the father is thinking, oh, my son may die, I may be separated. It is a sign of intense love. Not always that the son is dying immediately, you see, but he is thinking like separation. You see? So that is good sign. And we should not think that we are doing very nicely. We should always think that I am unable. This is not bad. We should never think that I am perfect. Because the Maya is so strong. As soon as you are little confident, immediately there is attack. You see? In a disease condition, there shall be one who takes very precautionary method, there is little chance of relapse. So, this is not bad. We should always think like that, that maybe I am not doing nicely. But as far as it is in our power, let us execute our business nicely, but we should never think that it is very perfect. That is nice.
If Maya takes a hold on one, what's the quickest way to go back to Krishna?
That Krishna simply, when there is Maya's attraction, just pray to Krishna. Please send me. This is the only way. And he'll send. We are in the Maya's kingdom, so Maya is strong very here. But if we catch Krishna very strongly, Maya cannot do anything. That we should be fixed up in catching Krishna very tightly. Then there is no fall down.
So, when we were on Sankirtan chanting, what would be the best way for us to engage the crowd and to become participants in the chant?
The best way is go on chanting. Your business is not to, satisfy the crowd.
No.
Your business is satisfy Krishna. And then crowd will be automatically satisfied. We are not going to please the crowd. We are going to give them something, Krishna. So you should be very much careful whether you are delivering Krishna in the right way, then they will be satisfied. Your only business should be to satisfy Krishna. Then everything is will be satisfied. That means to stay Jagat-tushta. If Krishna is satisfied, then whole world is satisfied. If you pour water on the root, then it is automatically distributed in every part of the tree. So Krishna is the big tree, root of the big tree, and you take to watering Krishna, chant Hare Krishna, and follow the rules and regulations, everything will be all right. Now, yes, any question?
Is taking prasadam one of the extensions
of love,
where we accept food from
our lover? Yes. You offer, and you take. Dadati pratiknati, bhunte bhojayate, vijyamakhya adipichyati cha. You disclose your mind to Krishna, and Krishna will give you direct an answer. You offer Krishna, that Krishna, you have given us so many nice things, so you first of all take. Then he shall tell Krishna, will you please? Yes, that's all. Krishna eats and Krishna puts again in the same way. Purnasta purnamadaya purnameva vishishtat. We are offering Krishna, that does not mean that Krishna is eating, but Krishna is so full, complete, that is leaving the whole thing complete. People do not even understand these things, that we are not losers by offering Krishna. We become gainer. You decorate Krishna nicely, you see, then your desire for seeing beautiful things will be satisfied. You know, no more will be attracted by the so-called beauties of the world. You keep Krishna in comfortable state, he will be placed in comfortable state. You offer Krishna nice food stuff, he will eat it. So, just like if I decorate my face, I cannot see how it is beautiful. But if I bring one mirror before me, the reflection of my face is beautiful. Similarly, you are reflection of Krishna. Man is made after God. So if you make happy Krishna, then you will see that he reflects and you are happy. Krishna does not require your service to become happy. He is complete in himself. But if you try to supply and make happy Krishna, then you will be happy. This is the Krishna consciousness movement. So try to decorate nicely Krishna, try to give all food stuff to Krishna, try to keep Krishna in all comfortable position. In this way, you will reciprocate all the things that you offer. This is Krishna consciousness. Material disease is just like the tail of the dog. Okay? The dog's tail is like this. And however oil it, and try to make it safe, it comes. So these people, they want material enjoyment. If Swamiji can offer us material enjoyment cheaply by some mantra, they will come. When Swamiji said, this is all rascaldom, come to Krishna, this is not. Because he wants to keep the tail like this. However, apply ointment, it comes like this. This is the disease. They want material things, that's all. If by mantra, if by some tricks, we can enhance our material enjoyment, it is very nice. Let us take some drug and become in the full paradise and think, I am in the spiritual world. They want life. They want to remain in fool's paradise. But when we offer real paradise, they reject.
All right, chanting.